Good evening all. Myself, Dr. B. Bhavani, Dean Academics in Chevrolet Engineering College and coordinator for this today's webinar. Now, I would like to welcome respected Principal Dr. R.V. Krishnaya Garu, Director N. Venkatrao Garu, and Director G. Mastan Chaudhary Garu, HOD of S&H Department, M. Srinivas Rao Garu, HOD of CSC Department, V. Dinesh Babu Garu, Professor Veera Raghav Rao Aathukuri Garu, Secretary Aathukuri Venkata Lakshmi Educational Trust, and staff member, students of our college, and participants from various different institutions of the nation. We are very happy to organize this webinar in association with Aathukuri Venkata Lakshmi Educational Trust, Guntur, on machine learning and its applications in food engineering. We assure that all the participants will have a very stimulating and accelerating session ahead. Before going to start the session, I would like to introduce my institution profile. Chevrolet Engineering College was started by Vishweshwaraya Educational Society on 2008 with four branches of CSE, ECE, Triple E and Mechanical. Each intake of 60 out of 240. Now it is grown to seven branches: CSE, AI and Machine Learning, DS, ECE, Civil Engineering, Triple E, Mechanical, with the total intake of 510. We have 5 patents and 1 undergoing project approved by MSME Government of India costing 15 lakh. Now, it's my honor to present a profile of Aathukuri Venkata Lakshmi Educational Trust. Aathukuri Venkata Lakshmi Educational Trust was founded in May 2021 in memory of Aathukuri Venkata Lakshmi by her husband, Sri Aathukuri Subbarao, a noted businessman and philanthropist. The chief objective of the is to promote and foster socially backward and economically poor merit strata of the society by conferring scholarships in the form of financial grants to pay their tuition fees and other educational expenses. The trust also initiates and promotes educational activities to empower students' career and employment development, like vocational training, skill-based training, preparation for entrance screening, and competitive exams for both public and private services conducted by state, national, and international agencies. Now, it's my privilege to introduce today's resource person, Dr. G. Gururaj HL. Dr. Gururaj HL is currently working as Associate Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Vidyavardhaka College of Engineering, Mysore. He holds a PhD degree in Computer Science and Engineering from Vishweshwaraya Technical University, Belagavi, India in 2019. He is a professional member of ACM and working as ACM Distinguished Speaker from 2018. He is the founder of Wireless Internetworking Group. He is a senior member of IEEE and lifetime member of ISTE and CSI. Dr. Gururaj receiving Young Scientist Award from Sir DST, Government of India in December 2016. He has 9 years of teaching experience at both UG and PG level. His research interests include blockchain technology, cyber security, wireless sensor network, ad hoc networks, IoT, data mining, cloud computing, and machine learning. He is an editorial board member of the International Journal of Blockchains and Cryptocurrencies and special editor of EAI Publishers. He has presented 30 papers at various international conferences. He has authored one book on network simulators. He worked as reviewer for various journals and conferences. He also received Best Paper Award at various national and international conferences. He was honored as chief guest, resource person, session chair, keynote speaker, TPC member, advisory committee member at national and international seminars, workshops, and conferences. Now, session is handed over to Dr. Gururaj HL. Gururaj sir, please proceed.
Yes, thank you so much. Very good evening to everyone. I think it's my voice audible.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let me share my screen before presenting. Yes. Kindly acknowledge once you can see my screen so I can start my presentation. So before starting with my presentation, I heartily thank my good friend of Professor Raghav and the various fellows of this institution for inviting me to deliver a talk. Thank you so much for your gesture and nice introduction. Thank you so much, madam. Can anyone acknowledge if the screen visible? Can I get to know? Yes, it's visible. Thank you. Thank you so much. Okay. Okay, thank you so much. I think the screen visible. So let me start with my presentation. Once again, very good evening, everyone. We have a wonderful talk on this evening called as machine learning and its applications in food engineering. The very hot topic nowadays, wherever you go, the people are lagging behind a type of learning called as machine learning or deep learning kind of thing. So this is one important topic. I think I delivered more than 100 lectures on the same topic across globe. Like it might be in Italy or Europe and various parts of the globe, I delivered the same lecture. What exactly the machine learning? In the first 20 minutes of the session, I'm going to talk something like, what exactly the machine learning and why it is important nowadays, and why computer is converted to a learning category, like how it is adopted with statistical intelligence along with its own learning strategy, like might be machine learning or it might be deep learning and all. After half of the session, I'm going to discuss various applications where you people also can able to involve how you guys can able to come up with the various applications of food science, taking the examples of machine learning or deep learning. Okay. Now, without wasting my time, let me begin with the important topic called machine learning. As I introduced, I'm Dr. Gururaj HL, working as an associate professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at Karnataka, Mysore. And if you want to check my recent books, recent publications, recent papers, please visit my website. It's me, guru.in. You'll get to know all the details, okay? Yes, I think nowadays all the mailing systems, whatever the inbox mails or the mails which we get, they will be categorized into three main categories. One is primary mail, social mails, and promotional mails. Okay, how it's going to happen? Okay, how it's by default or automatically it's going to happen? This categories is going to happen with the help of machine learning concepts. Okay. So this is one important example or application where we can see the intelligence of the machine by itself. It's going to delay, you know, categorize or segregate the incoming mails and put it into a primary, social, and promotional. Okay. The second important application or example to define the machine learning is, I think, recommendation systems. It might be not only in the case of Netflix, or it might be in the case of, you know, Amazon Prime or whatever. A person keep commonly watching, you know, comedian movies and comedian videos. They used to get the advertisement quite oftenly to see the recommended videos, correct? So that is what a recommendation system we can have. How that analogy can be done? Because of the learning things, because of the existing data, what the user has already watched, correct? So this is one of the typical example for the, you know, machine learning concepts. And nevertheless, the one more important thing is we can have digital traveling across the globe. For example, if you want to travel from Hyderabad to Bangalore or somewhere, you don't know exactly the path. What you'll do, the first step is you'll put on a GPS location system. Correct? No. So once after having the GPS location, you are going to switch on your GPS and also your intelligence in such a way that in the 4G technology and all, it's along with that, it's going to mention the main important aspect that you don't go in this way. If you go in this way, you're going to have a huge traffic there. Correct? No? So this kind of differentiation or categorization can be done with the help of this learning is called as machine learning. This is one more important application. And after having this couple of examples, there's a time to define what exactly the meaning of machine learning. Okay. Machine learning is one technology in which we are going to adding the intelligence extra to the devices, correct? So how the intelligence will be added? For example, we are making the kit to learn. A new baby has been born. What we used to do, we never make the kit to directly learn the sentences, or it might be to learn the mathematical equations. What the basic things we do, we will make the kit to recognize the actions, or it might be the visualized systems and all. Correct? In the same way, here also we'll make the machine to learn in the lower steps. Okay. So one by one, that is all the aspects of machine learning technology. Okay. So it's all about adding an intelligence extra to the existing system. Many people have a misconception that computer does not mean that only a machine that will be placed on the desktop table. It's not like that. Any device, it might be smartwatch, it might be, the digital gadgets, or it might be tab or whatever, that's going to have an able to capacity to store the data and communicate the data. It's called as a machine or computer. Okay, all these machines are enabled with intelligence. We can call it as machine learning techniques. Okay, so this is I can give an example for this. Usually the better example to understand about machine learning. What the machine will do, machine will able to recognize the things, machine will able to, by default, inbuilt libraries, it's going to identify various things and all. But basically, with the help of machine learning, for example, we'll ask the kid not to touch a vessel. What the kid will do, it will never touch that vessel. Why it's not going to touch? Because they'll inform already that if you touch this vessel, it's very hot vessel, it will hurt you. Correct? No? Or the kid will think, okay, if I touch that vessel, it will get in. Now, kid thinks and it keeps on learning, if I touch any hot vessel, it will hurt me. Correct? No? And the similar facet, we have one more important technology called as deep learning in the scenario. Deep learning is totally different from machine learning, guys. Deep learning is nothing but a technology in which it also learn and also analyze. But in case of machine learning, it's going to only learn the things. Okay, that's the major difference between machine learning and deep learning. In deep learning, along with that vessel, what it will think, the same kid, for example, okay, any vessel or any item or anything which is hot, I should not touch. If I touch, I'll get hurt. Correct? No? So that is a major difference between deep learning and machine learning. I hope so. I convinced you guys. So with this brief introduction towards machine learning, let me go with the next important topics called the types of machine learning. There are three categories of machine learning. One is reinforcement learning. Supervised, as the name itself indicates, we have supervised machine learning is nothing but it's going to have various labeled data. The data, all the data set, what we are going to give it as an input, all the data will be labeled. Hence, it is called as supervised learning. In supervised learning, we'll be having the restricted type of data, and all the data will be labeled. That's a major aspect of that's called as supervised learning. I think the screen visible. Especially in case of supervised learning, we'll be having a control over the data. All the data will be labeled. That's a major important aspect. By training the set of data, we can able to identify the next data. The prediction can be done. Okay. That is the overall meaning of supervised learning. The second category is called as unsupervised learning. We'll be not having any type of labeled data. The complete data will be not labeled, and hence it is called as unsupervised learning. And this data will be categorized based on the training data, the type of data what we have. Okay, it's called as unsupervised learning. The third category of any kind of data as labeled and non-labeled, and the complete data will be categorized based on some of the punishments and also with the help of rewarding. Okay, guys, if you have any questions at any point of time, you can put up your question in the chat window. I'll answer all the questions at the end of my presentation. Okay, if you have any questions, it might be layman question. I'm not able to, I'm not going to do. I'm going to, based on the data sets like color and the dimension, I'm going to call it as apple, and based on the same thing, color, the size and the shape, I'm going to call this as cupcakes. And I'm going to train the model in such a way that whatever the data of this category which comes into this model, I have to name it as apple or cupcake. Okay, similarly, if I'm going to enter a new data which is not a labeled data, there's a new cupcake. Okay, once I enter this model, it has to name it as cupcake class. Why? Because the shape or the size or the some features will be similar to the training model. This data is called as training data, and this data is called as testing data. Okay, this data is called as what? Training data, and this data is called as testing data, and this model is called as machine learning model. Okay, so and the output what we get is called as the class or category of the output. Okay, this is all about the supervised machine learning model. Okay, the second important category of model is called as unsupervised learning, wherein which we don't have any data should be categorized. All the data will be this data is called as raw input data. We don't have any segregation or we don't have any labels. All the data will be inputted to the system. The system will pass the algorithm, and based on the features which are inputted here, like it might be shape, color, or the dimension, and each and every aspect, it's going to categorize whether it's based on the features or based on the input value, based on the features and various other things, it's going to categorize this input into the, whatever the class it wants. Okay, this is all about unsupervised learning. Here we don't have any kind of input data with labels. All data, raw data, directly we can pass. Okay, and we all know that in the scenario, in the live examples for the unsupervised learning, we have a lot of scope. We all know that, and this is all about unsupervised learning. In the meanwhile, let me go with some couple of examples with this category. Okay, the third category, what we are called as reinforcement learning, it's similar to a category in such a way that how will train the dog. Okay, for example, if a dog does a good work, what we used to do, I mean to say, whatever the words we say to dog, if the dog listens, we'll reward by giving a biscuit. Correct? No. If the same dog, if it does not do the action or the words listened done by the owner will beat the dog. It's a punishment. Okay, this category is called as rewarding and punishment, and this is called as reinforcement learning. And we'll see one of the other classical classification example on this reinforcement learning meanwhile. Okay, if you have any doubts, again guys, if you have any questions, you can please, I'm very happy to take up all your questions at the end of the session, and I can answer all your questions. Okay, but this is all about reinforcement learning. There are two categories, one is rewarding and one is punishment. Okay, we can call it as actions and observation. Based on the actions and observations, how the dog learns, right? Based on the, like, for example, will you make the dog to bark at unknown people, will make the dog to come and sit and all, right? In a similar way, here also the machine will try to learn the things based on the observations and based on the actions, okay? One of the finest, unsupervised learning category, what we call as K-means clustering mechanism. This is one important clustering operation called as K-means. K-means represents number of clusters what we have, and this will take up the minimum distance with the help of this distance formulae. We used to represent a centroid node in each and every cluster. For example, it's all about cluster data. Once we have the unclustered data, the data will be randomly segregated across. And we used to identify one centroid in each and every cluster. Based on the centroid, the nearest points or nearest embedded bodies will be recognized with the help of this formula. And we can call it as, that node belongs to that cluster. Okay, this is a formula used. And this is all about the node's value. And this is about the centroid value. Okay, this is the distance formula. And this is called as K-means clustering operation. This is one of the finest clustering operation that will be used randomly for the raw input data. The second important category we have called as naive-based algorithm, naive-based classifier. This is not clustering. This is classifier algorithm. Okay, classifying is something, but if I give some data input for the machine, it has to classify whether it belongs to this category or that category. That classification will be done with the help of naive-based, using some naive-based theorem. Probability of A divides B is equal to probability of B divides A into probability of A divided by probability of B. Okay, this is called as naive-based algorithm. Okay, in this, the better application for this is we can have the categorization of male application. Okay, so the males which are valid, that will be categorized as inbox male. The males which are not valid, we have to categorize it as mass spam males, right? So this categorization can be done with the help of naive-based, one of the better example how the classifier works with the help of naive-based. Okay, this is all about naive-based algorithm. And one of the finest decision tree, what we have called as one of the finest better accuracy we can achieve with the help of this algorithm called as decision trees. And most of the algorithm, whatever the research you're going to do, all the researchers will use to consider decision tree for their research work, to at least to come up with exceptionally good output and all. Okay, why? Because the decision trees will be having a deeper knowledge or deeper tree of it. For example, if a kid want to go out and he want to play, what the decision we have to consider, whether outside it's rainy or it's summer. If it is rainy, the kid will go and out, go out and it will play. This is what all about classification. Okay, how it divides. Okay, and here each and every leaf node will represent the decision, and every branch node what we have represents the yes or no, or true or false. I mean to say the way how it can be decided. Okay. And this, the leaf node is a decision node. Okay, the minimum the actual node will represents the what? The actual node will represents the centroid, root node will represent the actual problem definition. This is all about the type of decision trees. And we have it induction and pruning. The main two important working principles of decision trees, one is induction and one is pruning. Induction is nothing but adding extra question. For some of the times, let me consider in the same example. If a kid wants to play a game and he want to go out and he want to play, he will check whether the environment is summer or it's rainy. If it is rainy, he'll be in home, so it comes false. If it is summer, he'll go out and he'll play. Okay, once he go out, he has to decide whether he has to play group games or because he has to decide whether the number of people are there or he's alone. Correct? No, if the number of people are more, he can go for group games. He's alone, he cannot play group games. He has to decide something else. Correct? No, so one or two is there, he has to do something else. This is all about, okay? And some of the situations within which some notes are not at all required, some branches are not at all required. In such situation, we have to go with a process called as a pruning. We have to delete those branches. At some situation, we may require some extra question. At such situation, we have to go with a process called as induction. Okay, this is all about dysentery, and you can take up the papers, research work, research papers, or whatever the existing papers. Almost all, 99% of the people, they are working on dysenteries, and a huge, you know, research is also going on this. Okay, this is all about dysenteries. Yes. Now, I think it's 5:30, I guess. Yes, exactly. And now I have to talk much on you know the various aspects like I have to talk on very important concept called as food engineering, okay, which is the talk of my day, correct? No, so food engineering, it is a multidisciplinary branch of applied physical sciences which combines science, microbiology and engineering knowledge for food and related industries. And especially recently past, they used to call it as food science, and nowadays they used to call it as food engineering. Why they called it as food science and now why they calling it as food engineering? The major important advantage of this is before 20 or couple 10 years and a couple and all, they don't have any kind of opportunity to adopt engineering knowledge for the physical labs or chemical labs and all. But nowadays we have the possibility of adapting all engineering technologies to the physical or chemical labs, hence it is called as engineering. Adapting the engineering technology to the science, and we can call it as food engineering. Okay, it's not only restricted for what it's not only restricted for how the food will be manufactured, the quality and quantity. Along with this, it has also have higher dimension regarding the research and research direction. And along with that, it's also having a huge advantage of new recipes development, hygienic of the food, the quality where the quantity and the type of food and where we grow the food, the soil measurements, and all this comes into picture. Okay, we'll discuss one of the other applications which are widely used across our day-to-day life and how we can adopt our machine learning knowledge to this food engineering technology. Okay, we'll see one by one. As I discuss providing the technological knowledge transfer essential to the cost-effective production of food products and services, and it also will be applied for diverse environment. When working in the food industry, there are literally thousands of different jobs available. There is something for everyone, whether it be quality, R&D, sales, marketing, manufacturing, and also it can be applicable in teaching and also in the government organization. Okay, let me check out few and various advantages and challenges that will be faced in food engineering. Okay, the one of the finest things, challenges, the sustainable supply, storage and transport of energy, clean fresh water and adequate food. Does not mean that whenever you require, sometimes we may have the flood where the data will be supplied, where the food will be supplied from the food warehouses, correct? No, how the food will be stored for certain number of days, what are the measures that are taken, whether the food are valid to have by the flooded people or something like that. Okay, so that all measures should be taken by the food engineering techniques. And along with that, farmland and the growing human population require new concepts of feed the world with meet the consumer demand for future in the world. And we all depend upon new recipes, new food style, and new things. Correct? No? How it meets up the new food style or new recipes. Okay. And also, it also involves in research and innovation in the food process engineering, food packing. It all not only the depends upon food engineering, food packing, and will have also focus on food security. How the foods are care, whether it's edible by this age of group, adults, kids, or whatever, that's category. All these will be giving attention with the help of this food engineering technology. We'll see one by one, some of the applications which I want to discuss in the next half of my session. We'll go one by one. Yes, applications of machine learning in food engineering, one of the finest applications of One of the finest applications of food engineering is improved sorting. What exactly the meaning of improved sorting? Improved sorting is nothing but the way how we sort, the way how we classify the vegetables when we buy the product. Okay, it will take a lot of time. Correct? No, we have to keep, for example, we have huge production of something, apples, or it might be mango or tomato, whatever. I have to segregate the fruits which are very ripened and not completely ripened and halfly ripened, and the fruits which are affected by birds, fruits which are affected by all these categories has to be done. How it can be done efficiently with the help of my automated machines? That can be done with the help of one of the finest technology we have that has been developed by one food industry called as Tomra. Tomra, T-O-M-R-A, Tomra is one of the finest food leading sorting technology which provides the better efficiency with respect to this food industries. Okay, so in which it's going to have better classification of the food products based on the color, based on the size, based on the shape of the tomato. Okay, so this is what the food industry and how it can be learned. You can check out what the parameters that will be labeled before labeled. We can use a supervised learning or for better understanding. You have to make the label data, which are say something like this or that, and you have to make the machine to learn if the visualization concepts there, how the whether the tomato is, for example, it is halfly ripened, okay, which is not completely red in color. I should not pick that tomato, and which is already ripened and it's about to rotten. I should not take that tomato. I have to take up the visualized proper dimension which we had fed into the machine. Such tomatoes we have to pick up. Okay, as the human eye sees, the machine also will see and it will pick up the product. That is called as improved sorting. Okay, we put in the same way that customers do and sort it based on that perception. Okay, that is what about the food category, and this is all about Tomra, and which is one of the finest technology we have. Okay, so the second important technology what we have is called as personal hygiene. Personal hygiene, I think nowadays we all we know the scenario, day-to-day life, and how we are facing the COVID situation. Especially in this situation, how hygiene the food will take, how hygiene will be there, that is very, very at most important. Not only I call it as important, at the most important. In such situation, a food plant, just like a kitchen, good personal hygiene is necessary. Ensure food is safe or not. Okay, I think in the last year, a technology company called as Kankan, very important company called as Kankan, signed a huge deal to provide AI-powered solution for improving the personal hygiene, which monitors the workers and employers' facial recognition and also object recognition software to determine whether the workers are wearing the hat or mask as required by food safety law. The accuracy of this technology is almost more than 95%. Okay, you think about a technology and what type of machine learning algorithm will be used here. Obviously, reinforcement learning. Any employee who forgets to wear the face mask, or it might be the cap, or it might be whatever the respective gloves that are given in the hotels or restaurants, they will be reduced with some salary. Okay, it's called as punishment. And who maintains 100% hygiene in the office, or it might be in the kitchen, they will be rewarded with some something. Okay, it's called as rewarding. Okay, this is all about reinforcement learning. That is what how it works. Okay, if the person is in the red color box or white color box, that depends. Okay, if it is identified it as a red color, he didn't wear the cap properly, and is in white color, he wore the cap properly, and all these things. Eat new, correct? No, and there is a huge market demand for the people who are coming up with the new products and new recipes, correct? No, and is it possible to come up with a new product and making the certain set of people to taste the product and then decide whether it's good or bad? No, it's practically not feasible, and it's practically not you know, not optimal also. So there is a technology in which we have to convert the machine to learn all the food combinations, all the food combination. If I involve any sugar or something like sugar cane or something, the outcome of that recipe should be sweet. If anything that is involved with some bitter neem or something, the outcome should be bitter. If something that is involved with the salt or something, it should be salty. All these food products items has to be, you know, come up with all food combination, and the machine will be designed. As much as a machine will be designed with all the various inputs combination, the best output will get here. So in such a way that, for example, the machine is already done with trying the machine with the help of some huge data sets already. What I'll do, I'll give a new item as A is equal to something like neem plus some B is equal to something like salt. What will be the outcome based on the percentage of it? If I would have given some 5 cups of salt and only 1 leaf of neem, obviously neem will nullify. All these type of categories, combination, all these things should be done by this gastrograph. Okay, it is one of the technology. And now, one more question. Again, accuracy, that the decision trees plays a role here. Again, the food products, water develop its sweet in nature. We have to identify the market strategy, whether the set of people, adults are really good to have spicy items, and somewhat aged people, they want to have some sweet items or something like that. Okay, we have to segregate. And based on the market value, we have to categorize and we have to come up with the new products. And once after come up with the new products, we have to make sure whether this food item can be given to a kid, whether the food item can be given to an anemic patient, whether the food item can be given to a diabetic patient or not. These kind of categories can be only does with the help of decision trees with the greater details, and we can able to come up with a product. Okay, this is one of the important company. They come up with a food products called as gastrograph AI, artificial intelligence. Okay, I hope you got some 3 to 4 applications of food engineering. And you may have a question like, how about though? Many people, whenever I give a talk, I used to get a question like this. One of the important questions. What about in flights, in aeroplanes and all? They used to supply the food items. What about those food products? Whether they are designed with the help of different recipes and all, how it will be verified and all? And all the food products, they have to verify, because we are at the above sea level and we are at the air, supplicant of air is not higher when we are in the earth and all, correct? No? So what kind of food is preferably we have to eat there? All these dimensions should be taken care, and we have to decide this food product can be given in the airplanes or not. Understood? This is all about the categories. This is all about the detailed knowledge on decision trees or any other algorithms. I'm not enforcing you guys, you have to go with only decision trees. You can also go with neural networks or reinforcement. Or you can also go with regression models, huge regression models and others. Okay, this is all about, how we can use machine learning concept for all these various applications. Okay, and the next important application I can call it as plant leaf disease detection. The complete life cycle or the complete food product of the any plant can be decided just by seeing the leaf also. Okay, this is how it's same as by just seeing the face of a person, the doctors, at least not 100%, at least 70 to 80%, they've tried to psychologists and all, they try to tell the inner feelings or inner thoughts, right? In the same way here also, by seeing the leaf of the vegetable plant, we can able to identify, no, this plant will not give better yield this year, this plant will have root cause or root infection or something. Okay, so this is what called as plant leaf disease detection. At the early stage of the leaf disease detection, that will make the yield of the product more, and it will provide the yield more, and can survive the farmers, and we can do best out of it. Okay, the food products what we got from this kind of diseased leaf are not so good when we compare with the other kind of food products. So we have to give much attention towards this. And how we can use this leaf disease detection for the machine learning? Yes, of course, we can use it by using lot of data sets, passing using regression models, or it might be decision trees, whether the plant is hale and healthy or not. Okay, so this is all about we can also use here the pattern recognition technique also. Okay, this is also, we can call it as plant leaf disease detection. And accurate disease diagnosis can also be done with the help of further addition of machine learning techniques with satellites, UAVs, land-based rovers, pictures from smartphones, and others. This makes better accuracy when we compare it with the machine learning concept, when we combine both the things. This is all about, okay? So when we talk about this kind of technologies, applications of food engineering, there is one important food engineering application I want to mention right away, right now. We all knowingly or unknowingly depend upon the food product, something like very important food products. One of the important food product called as milk product, correct? No, I think most of us they start with milk, correct? Most of us will be depend upon unknowingly or knowingly one or the other food products to our day-to-day life. And how these food products for milk product depends upon a cow, it's completely dependent upon the cattle. If the cattle is completely healthy, the outcome of the milk will be very high. And not only the quantity, also the quality, the lactose or proteins or whatever, the complete fatty content, the complete content of the milk will be very high. There is one important disease called as lameness of a cattle. And this lameness of a cattle, we don't want to identify the cattle after consulting with the doctor. Just by looking at the face, how the face turns towards and how the face looks like, okay? And especially the watering of the eyes. Based on all these features, we can identify one of the important diseases we have called for the, infection for the cow, we can call it as lameness of the cattle. Okay, this is one important disease where we can accurately come up with a good results, and we can we got very good results also, and we are working. And especially many people, those who are working on data science field and all, they don't give much importance towards data collection itself. Data collection plays a very, very, very vital role. Very, very important role. Why? Because the data collection, because once we involve in the data collection, we can do the complete process. The data collection does not mean that I'm collecting the data. Okay, so something like if we have to analyze the data, we have to segregate the data, we have to classify the data, that's called as data cleansing process. Data collection does not mean that downloading the data from the Kaggle and passing to some machine learning algorithm, getting some accuracy. That is not the output. You have to check out the data, how many data you have taken, and how the data, whether the data cleansed, clean data or not, cleansing, data cleansing, and data segregation, data modification. All these plays a very important role in data collection. Okay. So what we used to did for this project is we make some set of people to collect the photos of day-to-day, almost for 100 days. Okay, so wherein which we'll also get the citation for our data, and also they'll get the citation for our paper also. So this is what the logic we have to use for data collection. Okay, so this is one important application on data, food science. We can call it food engineering, we can call it lameness of a cat. And yes, we are into one more important application called as how the cleansing has been done. There is one important company called a Sokip, self-optimizing cleaning place. Sokip, it's same as, when we go to some, hotels or restaurants, we cannot smell the plates, we cannot check out the plates, whether they are washed properly or not. There is some technology in which they used to set some threshold value. How the threshold value will be does, all the automated machines will be clean the vessels and it will make sure it achieves that threshold value. While it is achieving the threshold value, the plates or any utensils that are served to the customers are eligible to serve. Else, we should not use those vessels. Okay, so this is all about, again, reinforcement learning technique. We can adapt, and using some artificial intelligence, we're using some machine learning technique, we can adapt. And there is one company called Sokip, which is working very fine. And I can see here the researchers predict that the system could save UK food industry almost 100 million per year. Okay, this is all about cleaning place process. And nowadays, yes, especially we used to matters a lot when you talk about machine learning, COVID and all in the situation. it matters a lot, correct? No, how best we can able to provide the best effort to make sure that cleanliness, the hygiene, all the respect to matters, correct? No? So this is all about cleaning process technique. Okay. I think hope you got one more application. Hope you got some knowledge on one more application. The next, very next important application, what we have called as drones for crop spraying. Okay. So many of you people never bother for, whether these applicants are required or not. Okay. Simply you guys will supply the applicants, correct? No? So whenever the plants will be satisfied with the water, you won't supply the water. You'll supply other, fertilizers and all. So this is a scenario and we used to follow. And there is a technology in which we have to check out the weather condition, the soil condition, the plant condition, the leaf condition, all the required conditions. And then we have to supply the respective water or nutrient supply or whatever. This is one more important technology we can use and we'll get the major outcome of it. Okay. I hope you got some applications on machine learning. And now, yes, one more important chatbot for farmers. In a local language, it might be in the Telugu language, it might be in the Kannada, Hindi, local language. By using such local language, we can able to touch the farmers. We can able to reach the farmers with the voice signals, converting the text to voice signals. If something affected to their, yield, or it might be the plant, we can immediately send the reply to the respective the farmers that can take a photo of the plant and they can upload, and immediately they'll get a voice image, a voice text and all. So this is how the chatbots also, and how this chatbots works basically on machine learning. How best we train the model, the best outcome will get. This is all about chatbot from farmers. Okay. I hope so. I have convinced your application. And one more important, very important application is crop yield prediction. Okay. So you may have a question, sir, why are you talking about all these things when you're talking about food science? Food science is not only about food. It's all about where we grow the crop and how we grow the crop. Crop yield prediction. And many farmers, especially in South India, especially in a place like Karnataka, many farmers end their life they'll do suicide based on the yield of their crop. Okay, they never bother how much yield. They'll only predict, I'll get only this much. I took loan of this much. No, I have to end my life. Okay, so how the crop yield prediction? No, we should not estimate the crop yield based on our eyes. There are other technology and what the market price for the product, and all these depends upon remote sensing crop health monitoring. It will monitor the health of the product. And also it will suggest the farmers whether this food product is valid and what is the market price and all. Okay. So this is all about remote health cropping and all. Many people are working on this crop yield prediction also. Yes. One important research topic which I want to discuss right now at the end of my presentation or my talk is malnutrition machine learning. What is malnutrition or nutrition? Okay. Malnutrition does not mean that the person or the kid, he looks like very fatty or something like that. No, it's not like that. Malnutrition, it's nothing but even though many kids, they used to have their food a lot. They used to intake their food a lot, but still they have, many kids, or it might be not only kids, many people also inhale or intake their foods a lot, but still they have a lot of, they look very pale or lean and all. Okay, that's not malnutrition. Basically occurs when the body does not get enough nutrients. It is about malnutrition. It's not about by appearance and all, which causes, include a poor diet, it might be digestive condition and other diseases. Okay, so this is all about malnutrition, and especially in India, we used to monitor the kid malnutrition. Kids malnutrition plays a very important role nowadays. How this malnutrition can be, you adopted using machine learning. We are also doing one project on this. This plays a role. And we surveyed almost all five villages of Anganwadi. And we used to take the food, what they used to give as a supplicant for the small kids at the age of 2 or 3 years to 5 years. And we used to measure the weight, height, and all the conditions of the kid. And we should not bother the food products, what they'll give. Along with that, what is the food products consists of and where those food products will grow. That is called a soil, what we've taken here. That soil is directly proportional to malnutrition or not malnutrition. Okay, and where we grow the food and directly depends upon the nutrition or not malnutrition. This matters a lot, guys. This matters a lot. Okay, this is all about malnutrition of food. And by keeping the complete records, we have built a huge, big decision trees and we can able to play around it. Okay, so this is all about malnutrition in machine learning. And usually the people will consider the malnutrition is not about how much will eat the food. Quantity does not matter. Also the quantity, the nutrients, what will take in that food. This is all about malnutrition. You can also do a small couple of projects in which we can adopt, you know, better technology, better unsupervised learning for the respective data. But we should not, wherever we go, usually the students and all, they used to do the machine learning projects. And they'll feel that we got 100%, 98% accuracy and all. What is the data size we've taken? 100, 200 and all. That is not. Once we can have, I think if you took up the example of cancer prediction, after the doctor decides based on his experience of 20 years, 30 years, he fails to decide. Correct? So after taking 2200 data, 300 data, a person may fail to decide or predict. Okay. So there are a lot of other parameters also required. Correct? No, same way, please take up large data. As much the machine you try, the machine works finely. Okay. By this word or this code, I'll come to my conclusion of my presentation. And I think this is my end of the presentation. Yeah, now I'll take up the questions from your chat window and I'll go with the things. Okay. I hope so. I had convinced a few various applications of machine learning. Initially, I spoke about some, what is machine learning, the types of machine learning and all. Later, I spoke about the various applications, starting from Tomra. You can see here, starting from Tomra, and we went with various other machine learning technologies like personal hygiene, Kankan, one more important application, and we have went with the GastroGraph, one more application, and GastroGraph to come up with the new products of the food items and all. And also we went with plant leaf disease and lameness of a cattle and saw clip, one more application, and drones application and the remote sensing applications, and at last research direction towards malnutrition. I hope so. I have convinced you guys with the help of my small knowledge. If you have any questions at any point of time, please contact me or you can share your questions in the chat window. I'm really happy to answer your questions. Can I get some couple of questions or something? If you have, how to collect food industry data? Is any? Yes. Okay. Food industry data. Yeah. The same question I used to get wherever. That's what I used to tell. Food industry data, I think, especially in Karnataka, the agriculture industries or food industry data collection is not so easy. They won't give the data easily because they used to have some, ethics and they have some other issues. So what the few data are readily available in the respective government, state government organization website only. In case of Karnataka, we have the data available in the state government food industry website, or it might be the other websites. But what you guys can do is the data collection itself is a major role. The data collection itself is a major role. Guys, you please spend few time to collect the data. That plays a very important role. Okay. That plays a very important role. Okay. You guys itself collect the data. Okay. You guys segregate the data. You guys classify the data. That gives a very important role for you people. Okay. So this is how we can collect the data instead of downloading the data from Kaggle or some other thing. Is any machine learning method? Yes. Mm-hmm. One second. I had answered Anand Raja. Swapna, okay, from where we can get a food technology example, the dengue prediction, we can get like dengue data sets. Yes, that's what Kaggle, I think you heard of this. Huge medical data sets are available in the Kaggle, and especially for this kind of medical data sets or medicine data sets, what you can do is you can contact some doctors and you can collaborate with them, you can talk to them, and you have to think of it, how the data can be collected and how the data can be segregated and how the data can be merged with and all. I think that is the best way you can do it. Yes, I think I had answered your question. And then we have, is any machine limited question put go? There are no certain technologies, ready-made technologies. You take this, you do this. Anybody can do it, correct? So that is not the right logic. There are certain machine learning algorithms available. If you guys want to develop or come up with new machine learning algorithms, you can also do that also. You have to use the existing machine learning algorithms and you have to try in the data and you have to check which machine learning algorithm is better or suitable for this type of application. We don't have any ready-made kind of application for this, that and all. I think I had answered that question. If you have anything, you can put up a question. Okay. You all know about food science and food industries and all regulated basically by one of the famous organizations present in Mysore called a CFTRI, Central Food Research Institute, which is present in Mysore. Okay, Food Research Institute. Okay, so for example, if there is a data warehouse, food warehouse. And if you want to supply that food to some flood and all, they will verify. Some new product, they will verify. Whatever the food product you're going to release, whether it's a meat content or it's a cholesterol content, they'll verify. All these standards will be verified by that food industry, central government organization only, called as CFTRI, called Central Food Training Research and Institute. Okay. So you can contact them. I'll show you the website if possible. I don't know whether it's... Yes, you can check out here. And many times the internships are available, and many times open days are available. You have to go there, the new food products, the new technologies. And they had developed one technology recently visited when I visited that organization. They developed a technology, milk packets. We decide based on the dates, correct? No, after 4 days, 5 days, yes, this product is not valid. Okay. They had adopted with some sensor technology with three, indicators, green, red, and blue. Green indicates it's perfectly fine, you can use it. Okay. And if it's red indicates, you should not use it. It's waste. If it's blue indicates, you have to use it immediately by today or tomorrow. Okay, the meaning of this kind of indicators has to be determined based on the quality, based on the contents of the milk product only. Milk is very sensitive to bacteria, correct? I think we all know about that. Lactomyces and all will happen. Based on that, they have come up with this technology, the sensor node. Immediately, it will come up with some, carbon dioxide and all. Immediately, when it releases, it will turn to green color. If it is less, the green color. If it is more, red color. If it is average, blue color. That is an innovation. You have to visit such kind of industries, organization. You will get to know the knowledge, what the people are doing, what we can adopt and all. I think that is the right way we can able to do it. I think I had answered that question. Can you give free application software to a while to promote over that plant lean? This is open source. Okay. See, what I can tell you is I don't know whether the screen is visible or not. So I cannot tell in that way. The leaf disease detection cannot be done as you guys said. One second, I'll show you one data if it is there. Okay. Let me check. Okay. I think it's not here. The what I want to tell you is the data set, the open source softwares like Colab can use Google, that is, and all. But I cannot tell that they are the accurate tools. We have Python. I cannot suggest. I can tell you which are the tools available, like Python we have. We have Colab we can use, and various tools available. Okay, so whichever you are comfortable with, you can go with it. Okay, almost all ready-made libraries are also available. Okay, how can I suggest the food data set? Yeah, that's what I think we discussed about food data set so far. Okay? Can you suggest me which machine learning? Yeah, machine learning. I had given one research direction like malnutrition and lameness also can do it, because the there are various families of cows are there. How they milk product, you can take up the images, certain images, you can pass the based on the various parameters, you can pass the data, you can train the data, and you can decide whether the lameness is high or not. I think you can do that also. And various other projects. You have to go around, you have to think of it, and you have to decide for diabetic or for obviously the medical and food science, so they are completely collaborated. You can merge and you can do that also. I think I had answered all your questions. Any other question? I cannot able to see any chat window. I think I had answered almost all your questions. If you have any questions or anything, you can contact me with this email ID. Yeah, I got one more question. Good. Yes, one second. How to integrate machine with other technologies? For example, machine learning or food science with other technologies such as you have to identify wherever the prediction. See, machine learning or deep learning is mainly on prediction. How the prediction will do, correct? No, wherever the chances of prediction, then you can amalgamate machine learning. For example, cyber security. I want to decide whether this mail ID is proper or it is, compromised with the third party. I have to decide. I have to predict, correct? No. So those kind of prediction, wherever we have the prediction, we can enable to adopt the machine learning techniques. Supervised, okay. Supervised learning, we used to give the data with labels. We used to label the data. But in case of unsupervised learning, we are not going to label the data. Okay. The data is raw material. For example, I have 10 cows, 20 buffaloes, and 30 sheep. I'll put that completely into the data, raw data. But in case of supervised learning, I'll make the cow each and every, this is a set of cow, this is a set of this. This is a set of this and all. Once we pass the data, we'll get to know. Okay. So that is the difference between supervised and unsupervised learning. Anything else? What are the difference? The engineering products, and I'm not able to understand the question asked by Kiran Kumar. What is it? See, semi-supervised learning is nothing but very much a very good question. This seems that you have some knowledge on this. Very good. See, semi-supervised, there are basically, we used to categorize machine learning into three things. One is supervised, unsupervised, and reinforcement learning. And there is one more important learning we used to call it as semi-supervised learning. Semi-supervised learning is an approach to machine learning, which combines a small amount of labeled data with a large amount of unlabeled data. That's a major thing. Okay, so I think you have some knowledge on the machine learning, so you asked this question. So I think I had answered that question. We have both. Semi is nothing but partially or half, right? So we have partially labeled data and partially not labeled data. It's called a semi-supervised learning. Okay. Professor Guru Shankar HB, can we use ANN for food? Yes, we can use artificial neural networks in the greater details and back propagation method or CART and all we can also use. Okay. So is there any relationship between machine learning, deep learning and yeah, of course we have machine learning. If the kid thinks that if I touch this vessel, I'll get hurt. It's learned, the kid will learn, correct? It's called as machine learning. The same kid will analyze. What he'll analyze? Okay, I should not only test this vessel. I should not touch anything which is hot. It's called as analysis, the first next step. And obviously, if you would have added this kind of intelligence to any machine, by default, automation works. Correct? No. By default, automation works. I'll make the machine saying that A plus B. Any two operands, one operator have to add those addition. Okay. So similarly, if I give by this. If I pass 2 plus 5, it will add. It's machine learning. If I pass 2 plus 7 plus 20 plus 30, anything, if it's operator, it will learn, it will answer. It's a deep learning by which we can obviously achieve automation. You can contact me later. I think I can answer. I think I'd answered your question. Send me supervised learning, I guess. Okay. Any other questions? If you have any other questions, I'm very happy to answer your question. Please come up with your questions. I think I'd answered almost all your questions. If you have any further question, please contact me with this mail ID. I think I had given shared already. I'll share it again. Or you can invite me for the respective institution for the talks also. And this is my website for new call for books, call for chapters, or call for conferences I used to organize. You can see all my updates in this website. Okay.
Okay, sir. Can we close the session, sir?
Yes, please, please, please.
Yeah. Okay. So, on behalf of Shaperoll Engineering College, today we had conducted a seminar on machine learning and its applications on food engineering. And we really thank Gururaj sir for his valuable time and speech in the meeting. And at the same time, we also thank Athukur Venkat Lakshmi Trust for incorporating with us and conducting this webinar. And we really thank Dr. R.V. Krishnaya Garu, Principal, and G. Mastan Chowdhury Garu, Director, and the coordinator of this webinar, Dr. B. Bhavani Garu, and the students from Shaperoll Engineering College, as well as the students and the faculty members from different institutions. And I hope all of you grab some enough knowledge from this webinar. And we end this meeting with this vote of thanks note. Thank you very much.
Thank you.